pH. One of them tells you if there's chlorine, and another one tells you if it's a stable water.
Oh, fantastic. That's perfect.
The ppm's in it. So, I mean, these, it get this, if for 10 bucks, it gets you on such a nice path to know it a little bit closer. I mean, this, here's the.
Oh, yeah, that's nice. Yeah, that's a nice one. Okay, thanks for showing me that. Yeah, because I want to buy one also.
And let's see.
So, 89 bucks to pay for that one. So, that's really a nice one. Oh, yeah, 1040. Quite simple and very nice, yes.
Yep. It's very delicate. You know, there's a.
Okay, there's a probe.
Yeah, I keep it in a solution. They give you a solution.
Oh, wow.
Let's see, it's a little glass probe on the bottom.
Oh, excuse me.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. You could back this a bit. Okay. It's not focusing anymore, but yeah, it's like. Nice.
Yeah.
That's a master's tool for all of us.
I think so.
Yeah, great
bar. So, you know, this is a nice starting point for me, and I'll be able to, you know what I'm saying? This is what I was waiting for.
Yeah.
And now I can log everything. Now I can set the water so that whatever I grow, whatever is in the container is going to be in a livable 7.3.
Well, supposedly the GANs will do that automatically to the water. So
if it's in a GAN state, but if you're starting out with just water and this and that and some salt, how would you ever know? And now, like I was saying earlier, some people do these in caustic, and the caustic is built into the nano because they never washed it. So. Okay. You know what I'm saying? So just think about this for one second.
I understand exactly what you need to be doing, because right now you're going to do the armisting, and we're all going to do the armisting, but what we're going to be doing is jumping over the armisting to extract the metals.
Ooh, yeah. Well, that's the question. Well, see, the armis is the thing that actually strips the metals. The ormus is what strips the metal.
That's okay.
You know what I'm saying? The ormus is what collects the particulates from whatever's in it. If metal, if it's food, if it's a stone, whatever it is, the ormus is going to take that property and put it in the water.
So in the water itself, you mean what is the armist part of it will attract those and keep it when we do the GANs and keep it, make it the transfers. It makes sense.
It a perfect
metals.
Perfect pH state, so that if I ever need to, when I walk into it or walk up to it, this is me. It's not at a level where I can't accept it or it can't accept me.
That's for sure. And it would be good to know if it's really what it's doing on the pH level. All the readings we could gather, I'm going to make a spreadsheet of EMF, Gauss, frequency. So we're going to have, in our group, we're going to have all access to this. So we're going to be, right now, all the people that are doing the work, like you, any work, but actually doing something, we'll be able to bring something on the plate, and from there, if everything goes well, and then we never know what we can put in action, and if my plans go well, and if everybody would make the tube cells to make me a bit more popular and be more credible in the sense that at least what I do is what I do. And because if I can work like a charm, so might as well. And do it like that. It's just, it was the same thing in the past. The cadmium cell and the circle cells were unbeatable compared to the other stuff. And now these two cells I've made also in circle cells. I've made also in you know, the Tesla and Fibonacci models, which are actually giving out fields and all that. So everything is there in the, and we have more devices. When I plug these on, the Tesla Magnetical gives me between 3 hertz and 20 hertz. And the average is 8, Schumann's resonance. So that in itself is a useful tool. Plus all the devices, all the circle cells in themselves give off a different frequency than another capacitor or than the McGrath or whatever. They all give off different frequencies.
We're going to have fun now.
Yeah, and type of situation also where when I put it on the car battery, which I had a setup on it and the inverter, when I opened the inverter and it opened the light, it stuck on 366 frequency without moving at all. 366.
Hey, I got to go to my cooker again. I'm done now. It's 10.
Okay, give me 2. I got to go to my cooker.
Okay. Okay, I got about another 10-15 minutes.
Oh, cool. Joe made a pen, a help pen, with a circle cell. I don't know if you finished it, but I know he came up with that idea. So I'm saying it, and I'm always going to say it when I speak about this product, because at the end of the day, kind of leaves some rooms for other people.
Oh yeah, have you heard from our buddy Zane lately?
Yeah, Zane is like the planet Neptune.
Oh man!
You see this? I want to show you this little puppy. Squeezer.
What is that?
It's a health pen.
Oh, okay.
But it's a ping pong ball with GANs in it, 2 wires going in it, giving 0.5 volts. The 2 wires are, I can actually get a reading. I'm supposed to get a reading on the tips of these, believe it or not. Plus, last time I checked, I was surprised it worked, because you never know, you know, because the wires inside the other one, they're touching.
Right.
I don't want to fuck up the nano coating either. And I'm going to make sure it doesn't touch the leads. Gotta leave it up.
Too lower. I can't see. There. Oh, yeah, you get a reading, huh? Oh, it's gone now. Oh, it's going back up. There it go. 30, 40, See, but it's on negative now again. It just jumped from that. It was regular. Now it's on negative.
Did it jump?
Yeah.
Did it really jump? Because let's see here. Okay. No, zero, because they're upside down.
Oh.
The leads are upside down. I just reversed the leads, put this one on the other one, this one on this one, and give me the positive. Just tells me where the positive is on both wires.
Really?
Yeah.
So anytime the negative comes up, you just change the two leads and it should be the other way around.
Yeah.
Okay.
See, now because of the weight, it's push, it wants to push. If I lift it up to 0.41, 42, and it gives out a voltage. So it's more powerful. But it could be, I could even put it even more powerful with this. Just add ping pong balls of gas.
Now, are you using the GANS itself or are you using the water?
In this particular case, there's a tiny amount of GANS and it's all water. So maybe 5% of GANS, 7% of GANS.
CO2?
This is a mix of all three, like 60, 20, 20.
Uh-huh.
Or maybe a bit less.
Have you tried to make anything, any kind of pure GANS yet?
Well, only when I need it.
Well, you know, Armin, you know how he's trying to, well, the way he explains how to make it?
No, I don't know.
Well, like he was trying to tell us how to make pure GANS, gold GANS.
I didn't hear that one from here. I heard it a bit from Keshi that I need to re-listen to. It's very interesting. Everything was made out of gold, but please explain it to me again because a lot of parts on that was working.
Well, Armin just says that everything you want, if you want a pure state of nano or a pure state of anything, you use the two materials, a nano coat one, and then just cross, you know, wire them together, and then that you'll create GANS that way.
So easy.
That's what he said. I go, that's all I need to do is just take two pieces of gold, nano coat one of them, put a nano coated wire between the two of them, put it in the salt solution, and bingo. He said, yeah, you might have to drop a couple of drops of NOA in it, but, or you know, the caustic in it, but you'll see. You know, and then I ask him, I go, well, should I take a pH reading? Oh, I never did that before. What the fuck you mean you never did that before? Well, how much caustic do you need to put in there then? Oh, I just put a couple of drops. What the fuck what does that mean? I can tell how many women, how many mom and dad pops that are making it. Oh, just go ahead and put a couple of drops in. It's like telling some fucking cook, hey, put some sugar in there. Well, how much fucking sugar should I put in there? Fucking half a box or three boxes? What the fuck? Oh, I just put a couple. Maybe you put fucking 10 drops and you're not telling me. Maybe you're putting one drop and I'm putting a 10 and I'm fucking up my shit.
Yeah. I know. Yes. I
understand. You know what I'm saying? So come on. Let's
measure things. They don't measure anything.
Let's write it down. I put 10 drops of this and 2 drops of that in. Well, yeah. Thank you. Maybe I'll try 10 drops and then 2 drops.
Yeah,
see what kind of results I get.
Yeah. At least have a benchmark.
You got to have a standard. You're starting with water, H2O. We know what that is, and we know what range that water should start at. That's got to be the very starting point. We know copper is pure copper. We know zinc is pure zinc. If you know the materials are pure, I'm almost tempted now, not this round, but the next round, to weigh the materials to see if we're actually losing it. But I don't have a digital scale. So if I did, I'd take the pipes and everything that I'm going to put in my containers. Now I have two standards. I have weight and measurement.
Well, forget the heat.
And then I got the heat, and I got another measurement. I'm bringing each one to an actual temperature, and then I'm cooling it to an actual temperature.
Holy shit.
So those are two more fucking standards that I'm just creating now.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? They don't know. How how hot should the flame from the flamethrower be to do the nano coating?
Yeah, you know.
Everybody's got a fucking different torch. Just burn it until it looks like it's kind of goldish.
No, because there's setting. There's a fine setting to put it.
You know what I'm saying. This is those are the answers you get. Oh, fire coated. Well, how are you doing it in the factory? Well, we're just doing it in the factory.
Yeah.
How are you making the Gantz? You're making the Gantz in big tubs? Well, we're just making it in the Gantz.
They don't give it. They don't want to share.
So at least now, you know, brother, so at least now, like I said, I've got four or five different things that I've got written down that if somebody says to me, hey, how'd you do that? Well, I can tell them, well, I have 6-inch pipes I took an arm's length of 14 gauge wire, and I know exactly my arm's length is 48 inches long. So I know it's 48 inches piece of copper, 14 gauge wire, because I needed something to use to hang. So I thought, well, I don't want to drill holes anymore. That's a pain in the ass. Somebody out in the public, if they didn't have a drill, then they couldn't drill a hole. So I thought, well, let me think about how I could do it. And so I thought, well, just take a piece of copper wire, wrap it around the pipe, loop it through it, and then make a hook. So now I can hang those in my container.
Yeah, that's what I did too, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So, but if somebody says, well, how'd you do that? Well, I have 6-inch pipes with 48 inches worth of copper wire wrapped around it, and I heat it up for 2.5 hours, and I have a thermometer right in there. It's a candy thermometer, you know, where people make candy. I know because it could go up to 450 degrees.
Oh, that's cool. Okay.
Yeah, but it's a candy thermometer, so I didn't have to worry about breaking it. So I know each time when I turn that thing on, the hottest those roasters get with water, maybe, I don't know why, but whatever's in there, I've had it on for up to 3 hours, and it stays the same. It's 225, period.
Yes, okay.
Water boils at 180. Oh, yeah. So it's boiling. And I know exactly how much water I use per lye. You know, I use 6 ounces of lye each time I use, once I add a pitcher each time. You got to add a pitcher of water because it boils out.
Yeah, okay, yes.
So I know that. So I have that written down. So I know exactly how much I got. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, that's good.
So last time when Zane said to me, I don't believe anything you've done, you don't have. Well, motherfucker. I know you are a nice person, but what did you write down? And how many times have you done it? And how many results do you have? I'm going to be able to, I'm going to take my book out. I'm going to say, these are my results.
Yeah. That's the way it should be. Yeah. When you put hard work into it, it's the best way to go. That's for sure.
That's where I'm taking my teachings and my lessons. And if somebody needs some help, I'm not going to say, you know, this is how to do it. This is the way I'm doing it. You want to try it for you and your family, and these are the results, and this is where we're going.
It reminds me of the protocol for testing a McGrath on the car battery.
Exactly. You know, you're going with you're making standards, you're making, creating sizes, you're figuring out the numbers, which ones are working and which ones are giving you the right amount of power and which ones aren't. You won't work on ones that aren't giving you anything, but guess what? The ones that are working, now you're going to do them again and again, and they're going to work, and you're going to write it down.
I don't remember doing something that didn't work because it's so easy. It's just 2 wires and fucking gas. Doesn't take a genius.
No, but like I said, but you know, the genius part is you don't even know what's in that Gantz.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You made it, but sort of made it. You put this, that together, and you don't know, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
At least I can say now to everybody, this is the salt I use. This is the water. Here's the paper from the water from the Glacier Mountain, and here's the testing, and this is what was in the water. You know what I'm saying? I got it all written down now.
Ironically, right now, in all the Gantzes that we use, they always pretty much give the same results in the voltage field. But when we get to the gold, when we get to the silver, then it's when we're going to really have fun there.
Well, I just can't afford to go buy that stuff. But you know what? You know what that you know when I was talking about this, you know who Sandor is, right? For that guy from Hungary.
Yes.
And I said to him, you know, I explained to him how my containers and everything worked and everything. And he goes, and then I went to the PH and he says to me, what does that all matter anyway? I said, I didn't say anything else after that. What can I say? I thought to myself, you got to be kidding me. You're asking me of course that all matters.
Well, everything matters. Science and measurement. It's a baseline, like any other. Yes, it matters. Everything matters.
I try to make something happen for other people so that they can
worst ask. Case, it matters just to know that it doesn't matter. But right. At least say why it doesn't matter. You know, like in their sense, maybe they have a knowledge of saying, hey, look, even if we do it, we know it's always 7.8 because GANs will bring it there.
Right. Well, I'd like to know. Well, I guess I'm going to know that for myself for sure.
Yes, yes. And that's the only way with this stuff is that path.
Yep. Well, I got to go pull my tubes out of the hot water. Cool down.
Yes, we'll regroup very soon.
Okay, my friend. Like I said, next week I'm going in a hyper production. I'll have my containers up and running. I'll be working on, you know, I got to go get some copper, strip some wire now. I got to go and I had a beautiful little thing how to make, Magrav coils. I still know how to make them, but now I'm going to have to make the thing that I made them. I got to go buy some new rods in order to spin them. So, busy week next week.
We should be synchronized tight on that because I should be very busy also. I'm already pretty busy, but yeah, once I get all the tools, I gotta fucking measure everything, write everything down, the time, the voltages, the amperage, the EMF, the oscillations. I gotta put notes beside everything and holy shit. I mean, but at least it's fun to do it. At least now I get multiple measurements and I get like to create something very useful. But if nobody gets to it and nobody reads it, it's not useful. And when nobody uses it, and I'm going to give you a recommendation to go totally on the plasmatic state, forget about plugging this in the wall and make the tubes or make any other capacitors. But if you want them to last and not have to worry about them, make those. Not one of them quit.
I'm going all plasmatic state myself.
And you'll be able to put different GANSes, test it out on the multimeter, see if you get differences. You'll be able to have them, wear them, see how the fields of it feels. And they're little magic devices. People do the food GANs, wear them, wear a little bracelet of one, little necklace, all little stuff that are like the GANs patches, and but you decide what you put in it. Ormus, anything you want.
You know me, my friend. Little ain't my forte.
There's all the size of twos when it comes to that. But if you want that, and if you want, because
I'll go right back where I was.
Okay, you're plugging in the wall.
No. I'm gonna make my unit again. I'll make it bigger, the biggie big.
Ball. Where do you get the power?
Well, I'm gonna. What do you mean to get it started? And that's why I want to make a little Magrav unit to get it started.
Well, that's the thing is. When you say get it started, you need to get it more than started. You have to give it the energy that you want it to have. Then maybe you could take off what energy you put on it, and you're not going to get that by plugging it in the wall. The only way you get plasma energy is when you build cells. People don't realize that.
Yeah, but there's ways to make...
And so far they say there are ways. But there ain't no more easier way, no more concrete way than to say, oh, I know it works because the time I got this transitional phase that I'm working on the material state to manifest the plasma, and it's a really, trust me, it's fucking strong. When they say on the star constellation, it's 48 capacitors, but there's actually 48 cells. That's a minimum.
Right. Well, I think you can make a cell out of a Mangrave unit, to tell you the truth.
A cell 0.5. You need 48.
Well, we'll create and we're going to keep going, but I can't let this stuff cool down any longer. Yes.
But keep in mind that nobody has started working on the plasmatic state so far. They all have in their minds that they're all far beyond that, but none of you have actually played with it. You don't even know how powerful it is. And McGrath doesn't have a shit power.
No. Well, yeah, in a matter state like that.
No, in a plasmatic state, you feel the plasma when it's strong with this stuff. When you build a star constellation and you get up to 30 caps, I've been repeating this a long time, then you really start to see the field flow visually and feel them powerfully. And then they're born in the confirmation. And that's only the beginning. Mm-hmm. Because by the time we used to get there, they didn't work anymore. They dry up. You always had troubles. Now you built them in a fucking day. One day.
Well, you see that little thing that you got in front of you right there. You know why you're getting a reading off of it, right?
Well, because they're GANS capacitors.
Right. They're being fed by that the CH from the carbon from the.
Yeah, it doesn't need to send the CH. I've been. This is not the first product I made. The
carbon. Oh, I know. I know.
They all work. Any models you use, they all work the same. They all give energy, but more nano coating, more drop. More energy at the end, but it's weirder. It's not the same flow.
Well, we're going to have fun with it. I got to get out there and get them cooled off. Yes.
Anyways, do what you want, but I'm telling you guys that the power, when you build a plasmatic system, you need the plasmatic cells to go with it. That doesn't come from me, that's Keshe. When they asked me to build cells for them for the feeding system, they only wanted 9 on it.
Mm-hmm.
It's nothing. Once you get to 9 volts, holy shit, man, it's powerful stuff. Powerful stuff. I'm mind blown. Like you need to. You're gonna have a big thing, and that when it comes to time to put power, just do that. When you get tired.
No, you'll see when it starts to get to that point.
Yes.
I got you in my hip pocket.
Yeah.
Why do you think I'm hanging with you, man? I got to have your power there.
Yeah, that's it. That's the only thing you need. You can do that to the world. The whole thing, that whole bit will start to work.
All right. Well, happy building. I'll talk to you soon here, huh?
Yes, perfect. Get crown chakra. Go build the device.
All right.
I know. Go.
Okay. We'll talk
when you're ready. Yes, very soon. When you're ready.
Okay.
Okay.
All right. Have a great night.
Nice talking to you, bro.
Okay, bro.
Great.
Bye.